James Covido, Corona May, John Quarantino, Social Distance, Hand Sanitizer, Lockdown, Alcohol. Hello and welcome back to Some Good News in the Philippines. My name is Diego, and this week I'm going to try to put a bit more effort into reporting the news. Instead of me reading a quick headline and directing you towards the sources, I'll be a bit more descriptive, while of course making sure that I maintain my journalistic integrity. So let's begin. Better late than never, several cities have finally begun to conduct mass rapid testing this week. Last Monday, Parañaque City government has reportedly been able to do over 453 tests. And keep in mind, those are not all just from rapid test kits, but that also includes the more precise polymerase chain reaction, or PCR tests for short. Over in Pasig, Mayor Vico Sotto announced last Wednesday that they have been able to test over 309 people. 303 of them have tested negative, while the other 6 have tested positive. And lastly, in Makati, Mayor Abby Binay reports that they have been able to conduct over 110 tests. If you guys want to know the difference between the two methods of testing, the rapid test and the PCR test, you can proceed to the link that I provided below. Local band Lions and Acrobats have released their official lyric video of their song Patch Adams, where it features submitted clips from fans, friends, and most especially healthcare workers holding up signages of the lyrics of the song in different and creative ways. Considering the crisis that's going on now, this awesome video could not have come at a better time. Like the band says, folks, hang tight. Do you still want to support our frontliners? Yes, of course, there is another way. Pop Junk Love, an online store specializing in handmade goods, has started a campaign last week called Dolls Who Dare. This campaign gives you the option to donate a handmade custom plush doll to a frontliner. And not only that, Pop Junk Love takes it a step further. The money generated from this campaign will also help the seamstresses. Since their livelihoods have been affected by this crisis, this is a way for them to still generate income. On how to order, please visit the link below. Earlier this week in Quezon City, the Armed Forces of the Philippines have deployed mobile kitchens in order to provide aid for those in need. According to the AFP, they are looking to feed over 3,000 families per day. They have started last Monday and hope to continue in the upcoming days, moving from barangay to barangay. Top Gear reports that the AFPs are well protected, wearing personal protective equipment like masks, gloves, and face shields. The military added that it plans to collaborate with more organizations and well-meaning individuals to keep this initiative going. And to add to that good news, devilishly dashing Derek and deliciously daring Dunkin' Donuts, damn, try saying that 5 times in a row, has been giving out aid to the AFP. On the images posted on Derek's Instagram, we can see Derek handing out boxes of Dunkin' Donuts. He captions, "Our AFP frontliners are working nonstop to help all of us. It was an honor to meet and help these amazing people today. Through the efforts and kindness of Dunkin' PH and Kapuso Foundation, the AFP will be able to bring help to those in need. Mabuhay kayo." Thank you, Derek. And yes, I dig the new look, my dude. And that's it for this week's episode of Some Good News in the Philippines. Again, thank you so much for supporting the show. Now, as I'm recording this episode, it seems like the lockdown has been extended until May 15. As much as that sucks, maybe we can try to look at it as a way to still flatten the curve. Because in all honesty,
I'm not going out there by myself.
So thank you, and see you again next week.